take immediate decisions. That is not to say that we want a minus rep in every member state, but what we want is that immediately decisions could be made. And there are different solutions to that problem. We tried the concept with the UK MRCC in Milford Haven, and it worked very satisfactorily. This is the exception of the notion of risk, because an MRCC operator has no idea of risk values, and what we recommend was further education in the field of risk. We come to what an MRCC or a MOS guy should do. And we come to a risk index, which is very much the same as explained by Omar, but we include the consequences and give that monetary terms. And you will see that. Insert the values of the risk in monetary units per hour. This is 13.34 euros per hour. That's a rather low value. But if you have a look to this vessel, which seems to be the Queen Elizabeth II, with a lot of people on board, you will see that the total risk cost are nearly 1,000 euro an hour. And that are the vessels which we need to take care of. The objective of the risk consideration are, of course, improvement of safety and the protection of the environment. Also, improvement of the efficiency and reliability of information flows in order to calculate risk is playing a role. The furtherance of the balance of economy of sea transport and safety is important, and improvement of the efficiency of legal and organizational aspects regarding enforcing of rules and regulations in the European maritime zone. I leave out the definitions of risk related areas. You can read it in the paper, but there is a distinction between alert value and a risk value. The basic risk equations is not very far from what Omar told us, but we have consequences and we have the separate effects of wind and age and visibility mapped out in an equation with also the consequences. This model has been developed after the COS 301 which was a European project in 1986. And the Drugs Administration was supporting MARIN in order to continuously develop the program. But at a glance, it's much similar to the IALA model. What are we going to do with the risk? That's an important issue, because you can can calculate risk, but if you are not going to do anything with it, then it's a nonsense. But what we do is using AS data, using the ship data as well as the cargo data, we apply a risk model, we calculate an alert value, and if the alert value is over a certain threshold, then we call it an alert vessel. And that alert vessel is indicated on the screen, and that provides the VTS operator or the AS operator with more information about the vessel, and he can come to the conclusion that he will follow that ship more closely. If it's a high-risk vessel, that means that the risk value is over a certain threshold, then you might do something according to future international law. That's what we try to figure out. How can we use international law in order to take measures? And that's very much in debate in the Commission. Whether or not that would result in further proposals. Anyway, the risk alert, risk procedure can also be used, can now be used by VTS operators in order to alert people that there is a risk vessel in the vicinity. You can do that not only for navigational risk, but also for the risk of customs or the risk for emigration. All need to have a separate risk model, and they can be alerted for those different segments: nautical risk, the risk for customs, and the risk for emigration. I have an example, but given the time, I will not discuss that in detail. You can read it in the written contribution. The fact is that we will use the ALARP principle as low as reasonable possible for the costs of a vessel which must make a detour, and the operational cost. And if you find an optimum, a maximum, and a minimum, that's the way how you can figure out the track of the next vessel, of the vessel. This optimization looks like this. You find optimization for, say, 30 or 40 miles from the coast. And if you have a western wind blowing against the Norwegian coast, then you will have, as a function of the wind strengths, the distances where you are safe. Distance is optimized with risk costs and exploitation costs. If you want to know something on the project, better note www.marnish.org, where you will find all the information which is free for use for everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate, for being right on time. Since time is running, next speaker has allowed me to make a very brief presentation of him. Let me just say, he's the nice guy from the Canadian Coast Guard, recently chaired as vice chair, at the ANM committee. Please, Mr. Chatelet, also known as Mr. Greencastle. Here is yours.
Thank you for this nice introduction, Bernula. Good afternoon, everybody, once again. So the objective of my presentation today is to share with you the business case analysis framework that we have developed and used within the Canadian Coast Guard over the past few years. I will give you an overview of what consists this framework, its use, its possibilities, and its usefulness. So, what can a business case framework be used for? Well, sometimes national authorities are often faced with decisions to be made on the type of equipment to use and the type of service providers